for your weekly news that you should care about. Here's Jean.
So, on Sunday, a pastor was killed and her body was found inside her Pentecostal church in southwest Oklahoma, where she went every Sunday on the chance that someone would come in to pray or hear a sermon. Isn't that sad? She didn't have formal times and whatnot, no congregation. She just went there every Sunday and she was killed. Authorities responded to a crane collapse on the Throngs Neck Bridge in Queens today. So, I don't know much more about that. I don't know how many of you guys know Resident Evil Master 12, Jacob. This kid rocks. His link is in the sidebar. I'm going to do a separate video for him because he sued his school district for not doing enough about him being bullied and threatened and all sorts of stuff. So go check out his website. Go check out his videos. They rock. He has videos of himself being bullied on, you know, and so I'm going to do a separate video more in depth on that. Dozens of children in San Francisco played a life-size board of the city's famous Lombard Street to celebrate Candyland's 60th birthday. It was also a trip down memory lane for many adults. They like painted the street like Candyland colors. It was weird. You can check it out. Fall TV shows. You can vote for your favorites. Link in the sidebar on YouTube. Go check it out. So the Lockerbie bomber was released from prison under compassionate grounds because apparently he's very ill. You know, if he doesn't die in the next 6 weeks, I bet the Justice Secretary Kenny McCaskill is going to feel really bad and may lose his job. Who knows? And they celebrated when he got released and headed home. They treated him like a hero, a national hero, cheering him on and all this other stuff. Nobody's happy about it. So, remember the Gen 6? Jesse Ray Beard, who was one of them, now interns at a New York law firm as he prepares for his senior year next month at Canterbury School, a Connecticut prep academy where Beard is highly regarded among peers and teachers. That's a great turnaround. Congratulations, Jesse. Okay, so police say a grandmother using a stun gun to rob businesses in Pinellas County. She tells clerks she needs money to feed her starving grandchildren. On Sunday, the woman allegedly tried to rob an employee of a Subway store in Pinellas Park. Isn't that crazy? The driver charged with causing a crash that killed a child and his mother on Monday early morning was drunk, according to police. 4-year-old Luke Ingoldsby and his mother, Ashley Ingoldsby, were killed at 5:45 when Natasha Searcy, 22, crossed the center of Skyview Drive and smashed head-on into their Toyota. A baby in the Toyota, Jacob Ingoldsby, survived but was seriously injured. Another male passenger in the Ingoldsby car was also injured. Okay, so you guys, if you've watched my Twitter, you know there is, I've been following this Megan Wants a Millionaire story. Found the murderer up in Canada, committed suicide. They're now looking for a 20-something blonde female, 5'9 to 6 foot, in connection because she she checked him into the hotel with cash. Isn't that nice? They know who she is, they're just not, she's not considered a risk to public safety, so they're not releasing the name. Police in San Mateo, California said Monday that a potentially very drastic event at a high school was averted when school personnel subdued a former student who walked into school armed with pipe bombs, a chainsaw, and a 2-foot-long sword. Wow. Columbine, anybody? Prosecutors will seek the death penalty against 3 men accused in connection with the July death of former boxing champion Vernon Forrest. Crazy. Convicted murderer. Phil Spector, not feeling so nice in jail. He wants better. He said, in a letter released Wednesday, that he fears for his safety and wants to be moved to a better prison because he's just not very comfortable. Whatever. far away from cult leader Charles Manson and RFK assassination Sirhan Sirhan. Mm-hmm. Jackson's death, of course, has been ruled a homicide. There were 86 minutes between the time that he went down and the 911 call. Propofol was administered the night before he died, but the doctor, you know, admitting that, said that he had tried to wean him off of the propofol and gave him less, tried to give him other things like Valium, etc. Hello, you have the Valium in his system, you shouldn't have done the propofol after that. So he gave in to Jackson's demand for the propofol finally. And we all know the end of that. So the FBI in Denver is on the lookout for a Shaggy Bandit. That's what they've dubbed him. The resemblance to the cartoon canine Scooby-Doo's sidekick. Investigators say he's responsible for 13 robberies in the Denver area and one in the Arizona area since June 24th. Holy cow. He's yet to use a weapon in any of the robberies, but the FBI says it's taking him very seriously. We don't know what he's capable of, and for everyone's safety and until he's in custody, we have to consider him armed and dangerous. Oh, so speaking of Columbine, there was a man who was obsessed with Columbine High School massacre here in North Carolina. He was found guilty on Friday and sentenced to life without parole for gunning down his father and then opening fire in his school 3 years ago. He's been medicated since during the trial, and he showed little reaction to the verdict, but he did say that he was sorry and all sorts of other stuff. You can read it in the sidebar. Okay, so you know Haley, the little girl Haley that's been missing for 6 months? Father was just arrested for burglary with assault. Federal charges. Authorities believe that a woman was abducted while she was talking to her boyfriend on the phone. The phone was found on Friday by a man mowing his lawn. They have not found her yet. So there was another standoff. A SWAT team, two police officers, a male abducted a female in front of her kids, and apparently it ended on, Wednesday night, last week. SWAT standoff at a home in Brookshire ended Wednesday night with the death of the kidnapping suspect and the release of the woman he'd reportedly abducted a day earlier. Around 7 p.m., the woman was released, and then SWAT teams were removing her. They heard a single shot. Once they entered, they realized he was dead, yada yada yada. So that's all I got for you guys this week. I will be doing a couple of separate ones, like on the Megan Wants a Millionaire thing and Jacob. So you want to know anything about these guys? Link is in the sidebar. So this is probably going to be a two-parter, so check for both parts. Because right now it's 16 minutes. Yeah, so catch you guys later. Bye!